What's up, guys? Welcome to my March 2021 tier list for Global OPTC. Yeah, there are some new legends here. As you know, if you've watched my last tier list video, this is how I go on doing this. So yeah, I have sorted all the legends into tiers from S0 to S5, so these are the best legends in the game. I don't want to spend the time to rank mid-tier or bad legends, since you're almost all the time never using them anyway anymore. So yeah, I think this system is a bit better and a bit more diverse. If you've seen my last video, this should look familiar to you, since I just loaded up the last month's tier list, and from now on these videos will be a bit shorter because I'll just talk about what happened in the last month, and if there's even any need for some changes, and then we'll just sort in the new characters. So I've put them in here for now, and yeah, you can already use this if you want to have an overview, and I just talk a bit about these changes. So we will start at the top, and just once more for my criterias. My criterias are quite diverse. I don't take clear rate into consideration because let's not be stupid, almost every legend can clear anything if you build the right team and if you switch around enough. So clear rate is nowadays just a stupid thing to look at. Look at captain ability, special ability, usability, and playability. So quick legends, legends who are strong, legends who have good special and good overall legends, and god tier subs all in one list. No PvP and no support effects. So let's start at S0. S0, last month it was only Roger. Now we have Luffy, Sanji as a new legend release, and yeah, they are exceptional. I think if I have to rate these two, I would still say Roger is better than Luffy, Sanji. But Luffy, Sanji is definitely way better than any of the three legends in S0.5. And yeah, he's also a 5x captain. Amazing ability, overheal mechanic, 2.5x attack boost, orb manipulation. He has it all. So yeah, he deserves the spot up there. I think Roger stays there, so yeah, nothing more has to change there. S0.5, Shanxcrew, Snakeman, V3 Law, I think that can also just stay like it, like the last month. Nothing should have changed there. There's still amazing legends, and yeah, I used any of these for the content in the last month. S1, there's still Boa, Odin, Law, and Bullet. And now there's, for me, also the Sweet Commanders and the German Double Six. The thing is, if you compare the Sweet Commanders and German Double Six to Luffy, Sanji, you will notice that they are significantly weaker, but you are comparing a god tier unit to another unit, right? So there's just no comparison, because Bullet, Halloween Law, and Odin, for example, are also way strong, way weaker than Luffy, Sanji, or Roger, but they are still stronger than most of the other legends. So that just goes to show how good Roger and Luffy, Sanji are. Don't underrate these characters just because they are worse than Luffy, Sanji, and come out essentially at the same time, because the Sweet Commanders have, as far as I can remember, an attack boost for strength, a color affinity boost, and a chain boost. That is three amazing perks in one special ability. And they are also a 4x strength captain, and 5x if you fulfill the condition of having defeated an enemy in the last turn. So yeah, they are an amazing captain. Also rainbow captain for 3.75, I think. So still better than most of the other captains. not enough for me to put them in S0.5 because I don't think you can just clear any content with them just because their Rainbow Captain ability is not strong enough and their specials are limited to their type. For German 66 it's Psy and for the Sweet Commanders it's Strength, but in their own league of their own type they are superb, so yeah, they will stay in S1 definitely for me. S2, nothing changed there because all the units are in already. The only exception is that Halloween Shanks joined the lineup now. Halloween Shanks essentially is also a super type int captain who has a good captain ability, a good special. He would maybe even be above all the S2 characters if it weren't for his stupid wording, is what I want to say. Because he's an int captain and he boosts int characters, but his special is for slasher, so you're quite restricted to slasher int types or something like that. And yeah, there's still more than enough teams you can build with him, but I would always build a V4 Lore team before I build a Shanks team. And yeah, so he has a good super type ability, orb manipulation, and a good special color affinity boost for 3 turns with a chain boost. So yeah, he's an amazing unit. The only thing that lets him down is that he's a bit restricted. So I think S2 is a fine position for him. If I look at all the other legends in S2, there's nothing that has really changed in the last month. I would still say that the normal Snake Man is one of the lowest units in the tier just because power creep just hits him more and more from time to time. He cannot compare to any of the super types captain abilities, but the thing that lets him stay safe for me is his special is still so unique. So the carryover special with the type ability. So I think it's still fine that he's in S2. And for all the other units as well, you can still use Sabo and Koala, they are an amazing sub. Kaido as well. Kaido is still used for almost every content to cheese it. And all the other super type legends can clear essentially everything in their type. V3 Akainu can clear anything strength-wise. Sugar is amazing. Soba Mask is an amazing sub and a good captain. And Vivi and Rebecca are the best sub in the game. And Luffy and Law, still a good sub in my opinion. Not that good of a captain anymore, they are too weak by now. Then if we look into S3, I think I already changed something around from last month, and that is that I put Cracker one tier up, just because he was used quite frequently last month, and already now in the anniversary in some teams, just because he's a unit with an amazing special ability. So yeah, he changes orbs, he gives you a color affinity boost, he gives you a chain boost, so he's a really really good sub, and for that I've put him one up. For the other units, yeah, Miok and Perona, you could argue that they are also an S2 unit, but I have really never ever used them as a captain, only as a sub in Garb Challenges teams, and even then you're still quite hindered in using them just because they can't deal with all debuff protection. Well, you could say it's the same for Kaido because he can't deal with Nao, but Kaido clears every other content immediately without even having to think about building a real team. You're just looking for a debuff remover and then Kaido clears it. So yeah, Kaido is on a lower level than Miok and Perona. So I think it's fine that they are in S3. Corazon and Rayleigh are both amazing subs for almost every team. Even without their support abilities, they are used frequently, even in the highest difficulty. So yeah, they should definitely stay there. Stampede Luffy inbound captain ability was also used in the anniversary team, so he's fine in S3. And Sanji and Judge as well, they were also used just because they're a powerhouse unit that has an amazing special ability and can also use amazing supports because there's a Sanji, and Sanji has some really really good supports in the game. For S4, I think what I did to last month, if I remember correctly, was I moved Smoker down from S3 to S4 just because I hadn't owned him before. I didn't own him, and I personally thought he would be stronger than he really was, but he's also a quite restricted legend that is just missing some good utility, because if you want to use him to his full potential, you always have to use his special ability one turn before a burn ability comes in, and almost all the time burn ability doesn't happen on final stages, so you have to use him somewhere prior, and that restricts him so much I just don't like using him. And maybe him and Komurasaki and Deadbeard would be way more up if Quick wasn't such a bad type, but yeah, Quick is a bad type, and that's why they are almost never use these units, never. Only if there's strength content, but even if there's strength content, you would rather use Soba Mask or Sugar or Shanks Crew, and never these units. Komurasaki is a bit different. Komurasaki has, for me, a better special than Smoker and better usability, but yeah, also only restricted to Quick. And so yeah, she's a really good legend, but she also is not moving up. And like always, don't get me wrong here, these units from S0 to S5 are all superb, but there has to be a differentiation, and yeah, it has to be made like this. There has to be some differences. The Halloween Ace is still a really really good character. He's just not often used because he has a fighter and shooter special, I think, and these are not two of the best classes. He's just used mostly for his captain ability to beat that specific type of content, and that is so rare nowadays that I won't move him up any more than S4. Big Mom never used as a captain, but still the best int character for her switch ability that guarantees a matching orb on her and gives her a little boost, and she also has an amazing special, so yeah, she's very very well fitted in S4, maybe even S3, you could argue with that. I think I moved Hawkins and Sabo down. The thing is, these two units probably can also clear all the gap challenges and not the highest difficult content like Revo 2 or something, or Dofi 2, but they can still clear the normal gap challenges. It's just that you won't use them because there's just better characters. You will never use Hawkins because Kaido is the best Dex captain, and if you are not using Kaido because there's Nao, you will use Kid before Hawkins just because Hawkins is so slow. It doesn't matter if a unit is really really good and can clear the content as another unit if you are never using the unit just because the unit is too slow. It doesn't matter. That being said, if you don't own Kid and if you don't own Kaido and you just own Hawkins, it's still fine. You just need some more time, he will clear the content for you. But yeah, like I said, you're probably not gonna use him. The same for Sabo. Sabo has even more problems than Hawkins just because there's Snake Man, there's Luffy Sanji, there's Oden, there are the Sweet Commanders, there's Sabo Koala, there's V3 Akainu. You will use all of those legends before you use Sabo as a captain, and his special is not good enough to guarantee him a spot farther up. Carrot is just lackluster at the moment, I think. I personally think that in the next few months she will drop out of my S tier completely. just because she can still farm more easy content, very efficient, and she is for that still a really good captain. But the hardest content right now, like Colosseums, the final bosses have like 40 million HP, and she just can't deal with that anymore. She just can't. It's just not enough damage in her kit so that she can clear it. So yeah, she's also a niche character at the moment, and that's why she's only in S5 and will probably drop out in the next month. And Whitebeard and Marco still can clear all the garb challenges because they cleared them all the time, but the same like Sabo and Hawkins, they are not gonna be used if you own any of the other legends, just because they are so slow. They are still a good sub, but you almost never needed to use this unit for healing, and that's the only thing they are really good at, healing. And yeah, everything takes forever with them. Still, they can clear it, but yeah, you're not gonna use them. So yeah, guys, what do you think about this list? If you liked my last list, I think you should like this as well. Nothing much changed really. I moved some units from S3 to S4, S5 to S3, and so on. That doesn't really matter, right? The new units, I think, are placed good where they are placed, but still, everyone is entitled to their own opinion. I could also see you moving the sweet commanders and Drummer 66 one down or one up. It's at the end of the day, it's your own preference how you want to play the game. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video and have a nice day.